In this video, I want to show you how to use the TVM calculator to complete some of your assignments in Unit 3. Let's begin by calculating the future value using the TVM. So we have this example where we find the future value of an account after 3 years. If the present value is $900, the APR is 8%, and the interest is compounded quarterly. I'm going to highlight some of the important features and numbers that are in this problem. So we see that we need the 3 years, the $900, the 8%, and the fact that it's compounded quarterly. In the TVM, we have several options, and so here they are. That corresponds to the PV, which is the present value, is $900. The rate, which is 8. The period, which is 12. Now, this is a little different because this number we actually have to get from the problem, and we get that from the number of years times the number of compoundings. So 3 times 4 is 12. And we want to solve for the future value. So let's look at that in the TVM calculator. So here we want to do $900 for the present value. Since this is money that has left our pocket, we're going to make it negative with an 8% interest rate. We aren't going to make any payments. We're just leaving the $900 in there for 12 compounding periods. And it was compounded quarterly. And then since we wanted to calculate the future value, we put FV. So the answer to that would be our account would have $1,141.42 in it at the end of that time period. Let's look at one where we make payments. So we can add payments in the TVM calculator. So suppose we have a savings account that earns 7% APR. We deposit $20 into the account at the end of each month for 5 years. We want to figure out what is the account balance after those 5 years. And let's assume here that it's also compounded monthly. So here's the important things we need. We need the APR, which is the rate, the amount of money that we're depositing, that'll be the payment, and the fact that it was over 5 years. So 5 years compounded monthly would be 5 times 12, which is 60. So we'll end up having 60 payments. The things we need to input into the TVM calculator are the following. The present value, which is 0, we'll assume that we don't have any money. The rate, which is 7%. The payments, which is $20. The periods, which was 60. And we're going to solve for the future value. So again, for the present value, we'll assume there was nothing. We had a 7% APR. We're paying $20 into the account, notice the negative, for 60 payments for 5 years, once a month, and again, compounded monthly. So our future value in this account would be $1,431.86. Now let's calculate the payment. So suppose you're a student needs to deposit some money into an account. And this account has a 7.2 APR. And they want to have $10,000 when they go off to college in 5 years. We need to figure out how much does that student need to deposit. So here's the important information. The fact that it was monthly. The fact that it was has an APR 7.2%. We want it to have $10,000. And we're going to do this for 5 years. So we're going to assume again that the student did not have an initial deposit. It's rate of 7.2. If we're going to do that monthly for 5 years, that would be 60 payments. We would end up making 60 payments and have the account worth $10,000 at the end. And we're going to solve for the payments. So going back to the TVM, again, our present value was nothing. This time we had a 7.2% interest rate. We want to solve for payments, so I'm going to clear that out. Again, 60 periods, and then we want the future value to be $10,000. So notice this time that my future value, I'm going to make it positive because that's how much we can withdraw from the account, and so our payments a month would need to be $138.96, or rather that student would need to deposit into the account $138.96. Let's look at the present value for a nest egg. So a student determines that when they retire at 67, they want to have a steady income from a savings account. They decide that they can live comfortably on $3,000 a month. If they begin saving when they're 25, how much would they need to invest in an account that earns 2% APR compounded monthly? And again, we'll assume that they'll receive the retirement payments for 20 years. So here's the important information. The fact that they want to receive $3,000 a month, they begin when they're 25. They need to invest, or they're going to invest it at 2%, and they want to receive the payments for 20 years. Really, the begin saving when they're 25 perhaps isn't really necessary, and I've highlighted it incorrectly. Really, what we need is the fact that we're going to see 20 years worth of payments, and we want it at $3,000 per month. So we're going to solve for the present value. That's how much we need in the account when we retire in order to receive $3,000. We have a 2% interest. If we want the payments to be received over 20 years monthly, that would be 20 times 12, which is 240. And then the future value is nothing, because we want to assume that by the end of our retirement, we have withdrawn everything from our nest egg. So let's look at that. So we're going to solve for the present value. Our interest rate was 2%. We want to receive $3,000 over a period of 240, and that is months, and our future value is going to be zero. So we need in the account $593,222.10 when we retire. So we need about $600,000 in the account in order to receive $3,000 a month during our retirement.